Identical twins form when one sperm fertilizes one egg to become two babies, and fraternal twins form when two sperms fertilize two eggs to become two babies. Looks like we have more time. When a man and a woman meet, and they love each other very much, they may decide to have a baby. If they don't decide to have a baby, but have one, we call that baby a mistake, or the politically correct term, unplanned. Twins are produced mostly randomly, and there's only a 1-2% chance of birthing twins. Because of this, couples typically expect one baby. So if you are a twin, one of you is always an unplanned mistake. For normal birth, the man injects his sperm into the female's uterus to fertilize her eggs, and after 8 to 10 months of gestation, a baby is born. But with twins, two babies burst out. So what's going on? Let's look closer at cells. Your cells contain the information that it takes to make you as DNA within chromosomes. You have 23 pairs, or 46, chromosomes. One of each pair of chromosomes is from your mother, and the other from your father. They're different, but they code for the same things, one having your mother's traits and the other your father's. Each chromosome is made up of two chromatids. These chromatids are identical to one another. There is one pair of chromosomes that are not the same, and they determine your gender. These are the X and the Y chromosomes. If you have an X and an X, you're a female. If you have an X and a Y, you're a male. Most of your cells, like hair, skin, brain, and heart cells, the somatic cells, undergo mitosis to reproduce. In mitosis, each chromosome's chromatids are separated, one going to each of the new cells. Then they replicate themselves to form a new chromosome. This results in two cells that are identical to the first one, each with the full 46 chromosomes. But the sex cells, your sperms and your eggs, undergo a different process called meiosis. There are two important differences. Before the chromosomes split apart, they swap some of the genes. This is called crossing over. It creates chromosomes different from the parent chromosome. The other difference is that they split twice, making four cells, each cell with only one chromatid from each of the chromosome pairs. So each of these cells only has 23 chromosomes instead of 46. When they meet the sex cell of another person, the new cell they form will have 46 chromosomes, 23 from each parent. Then they'll replicate like in mitosis to form 46 full chromosomes and eventually a new person. What's the point of this? Let's say this represents genetic diversity. A lot of organisms don't reproduce sexually like us. They reproduce through mitosis, which creates offspring that's usually very close genetic copies of the parent. But sexual reproduction produces offspring which is a combination of the parents, allowing for a mixture of their genes. This creates more genetic diversity, allowing for a greater chance of getting more fit individuals. Ignoring crossing over, there are 70 trillion different combinations of the two parents. That's like a 7 followed by a trillion zeros. Crossing over creates even more diversity. The more diversity, the greater the chance of having an offspring that has something that will let it do well enough to breed again. While males produce a whole load of sperm, females produce only about one egg a month, each ovary taking a turn every other month. But sometimes, each ovary produces an egg on the same month. If both of these eggs get fertilized, then you get fraternal twins. Because these twins are formed from completely different eggs and completely different sperm, they are no different than any other sibling. They're each their own separate genome, compiled from their parents, and can even be different genders. When the sperm meets the egg, they become a zygote. Sometimes a zygote will spontaneously divide into two zygotes. Since each zygote has the same DNA, they will form two people that are genetically identical. Identical twins. But there's something different in females. Every cell in the female's body really only uses one of the X chromosomes. The other is deactivated. This happens pretty early on in development. So any trait that the X chromosome codes for will be different in any given area of cells. Some cells will have the father's traits and some the mother's. This can lead to some interesting things, like one identical twin female having colorblindness or hemophilia and the other not. This is most easy to see in calico cats. The color of their fur is coded by the X chromosome, so whether orange or black remains depends on which parent the trait is coming from. So identical twin calicos will look different. Sometimes after the zygote splits, the two zygotes will conjoin. This is how conjoined or Siamese twins are formed. The Grand Banks cod was one of the biggest populations on the planet. So what happened? Well, it turned out cod was made of meat. And because of advances in technology, cod catch reached record levels. The researchers and local fishermen warned about the declines in population. So why didn't it stop? The way the system was set up, the Department of Fisheries and Oceans